Today we are going to start the topic subject verb concord or subject verb agreement. So what is subject verb agreement? First of all, suppose I speak, he's sitting on his seat. Or next I speak, they are sitting on their seats. Moreover, Ram and Shyam are good friends. So for example, I write,
ma'am, your voice is not audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Now it's audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Some connection was loose. Okay. Next, afterwards, I repeat for you that when two subjects, they are joined with and, then ultimately, they take plural verb. What they take? Plural verb. For example, Ram and Shyam are good friends. Okay? Right? He and his neighbors are going for the party. They are joined with and. So this is the reason why they take plural verb. Next, afterwards, we are having, if two subjects refer to one idea, then what they take? They take singular verb. Can you give an example? One idea, for example, bread and butter. Bread and butter, what they refer to one idea, that is breakfast. Bread and butter is my favorite breakfast, or is simple breakfast. Then rice and curry makes delicious food. Okay, slow and steady wins the race. Okay, so what is this? It means that they are referring to single person. What they are referring to? Single person. Okay, next. Sorry, single idea. But when two singular subjects refer to one person only, then also they take singular verb. How? For example, the director as well as the writer of this film has got the award. It means the writer as well as the director, they are the one person, only one person. Okay, the principal and the secretary of the school is visiting today. It means the one who is the principal is also the secretary of the school. So it means he is visiting today. Okay, it means that both these different persons, although they are at different posts or they refer to different two subjects, they refer to different, but they refer to one subject only, one person only. So this is the reason why we are taking singular subject. Okay, next is when two subjects, singular subjects, are joined with as well as and with. As well as and with is joined. Two subjects they are joined with as well as and with. Then what it refers to? The verb follows the first subject. For example, I as well as he. Kya aega? A dash interested in this book. So what can be the change? So what will be the verb? Yes, why are you standing? Yes. Yes. Tell me, what can be there? I as well as he. I told that when two subjects, they are joined with as well as. Okay. Then the verb, it follows the first subject. So what can be filled here? I as well as he. Wrong. With it follows first subject. With I you use is am. This is the right answer. I as well as he am interested. Okay. Right. In speaking, you don't speak in this manner. It means that whenever you are speaking, it is wrong. Okay. For example, they with his friend dash gone to the party. Yes, they with his friend are, because it will follow the first subject. What it will follow? It will follow the first subject. He, because I ke saath kya hai? It will follow the first subject. First subject ko follow karega na wo. So what is first subject? I. Right? Okay. No, he ke saath hai. Me, it will follow this. No, it will follow this because as well as hai na, so it will follow this. Okay, because what we are speaking is, I ke saath hi am lagega, you ke saath are, you ke saath is to nahi na lagega. Theek hai, right? Next is when two singular subjects are joined with or either or neither nor then what they take? They also take singular verb. What they take? Students are still entering the class. I don't know why they are always late. Akhilesh again late. What they take? They take singular verb. What they take? They take singular verb. How they take singular verb? For example, either you or he has broken the glass. So here now see in this case, this is singular, suppose this is singular. So what it will take? I told two singular subjects they are joined with or either or. Okay, either or neither nor. So what it will take? It will take singular subject. So it can be has broken the glass. Okay? Yes. Right? Okay? For example, neither he nor his brother has come for has come to the school. Okay? So now it means that both the subjects, they are singular. Either he or his mother is coming to our house. Both the subjects are singular. Dono subjects singular hai na? Both the subjects are singular. So in this case, what is there? They will take, what they will take? They will take singular subject. Singular verb. Clear now? But see the next case of this one. See the next part of it. If two or more subjects, no, I'm not saying singular, two or more subjects, they are joined with same, either or, neither nor, whatever, right? Or, then what it will follow? The verb will follow. The nearer subject. Okay, for example, he should I not write on the board? Either he or his friends coming for a visit. So now see here in this case. Either he, I told that when two or more subjects, how many subjects? Two or more subjects. Okay. When two or more subjects, they are joined with either or, neither nor, or only or, then what will happen? The verb will follow the subject which is nearer. Here, two subjects are there, he and his friends. Two subjects are there. It will follow the nearer. What is the nearer subject? His friends. So what will be the verb here? It is plural, so it will be plural. Okay, if I change it. Okay, suppose neither they nor I dash going whatever it is. So now here they is plural and I is singular. So what it will follow? It will follow the nearer subject. So what is the nearer subject? So what will be the verb? Am. So it means that it has two different cases, right? First one is when two singular subject, here both the subjects are singular. Okay, singular hai na dono? So then what will be the verb used here? Singular verb. It will take singular verb. But in case one subject is singular, one subject is plural. Okay, Raghav, you stand up from here. Go there. And in my period, you should be in that line only, Delhi. Please go. So, now in this case, what is there? So, in case when one subject is plural and another is singular, it can be both the cases. Last one, the second subject can be plural or the first can be plural. So, what will happen? The verb will be according to the nearer subject. Jo nearer subject hai, uske according ho. Clear now? Two cases are there. So it will follow the nearer subject. Jo nearer hai, you will see the nearer. So then it will take singular verb. Okay, then what it will happen? It will take only singular verb. Okay, clear this one? Next is when stand up please, Dilpreet, come here please. So see here, so now when there is use of, or when there is each of every of. Okay, so then they will take, when two subjects are joined with each of, every of, then what they will take? They will take singular verb. What they will take? Singular verb. For example, each of the students. Each of the student dash absent. What it will take? Each means singular. Okay, so what it will take? Singular verb is, right. So what can be there is, for example, everyone of all the classes present. Okay, so in this manner, what they will take? They will take singular verb. What they will take? They will take singular verb. Okay. Now, when there is use of, you can say besides and together with. Okay. Then what it will take? It will take, you can say singular verb. What it will take? Singular verb. For example, he together with his friends. Okay. Then it will take is going. Okay. Together with and besides, what it will take? It will take singular verb. Okay. He, for example, he besides his mother. Okay, or they besides their mother. Okay, so then it will take plural. Right? Otherwise, it will take singular one. So now coming up to the next one main thing, that is the name of the countries. The name of some of the countries, they are in plural. For example, full form of this, United Arab Emirates, Netherlands, okay, United States of America. What they are? They are in plural, but what they take? They will take singular verb. Duck, stand up, what I have spoken now. Which rule? Yes. Yes? Give the answer. So, ultimately, when the names of the countries, right? When the name of the countries, they are in plural. For example, United Arab Emirates, United States of America, okay? Or you can say Netherlands, they are in plural, okay? United States of Russia, okay? So then ultimately, but they take singular verb, okay? For example, the United Arab Emirates is a rich country, or it is enriched with oil fields, okay? United States of America is a developed one, right? So they seem to be plural, but what they take? Sit down. But what they take? Singular verb. What they take? Singular verb. Now, some of the subjects, they seem to be plural, but they are, but actually they are singular. Can you give an example? For example, mathematics. Economics, physics, aerobics. What you say? Physics are my favorite subject. No. What you say? Physics is my favorite subject. Mathematics are tough subjects. No. Mathematics is tough subject. Aerobics is good for health. You don't say aerobics are good for health. Okay. So what it means that they take singular verbs. Okay. They seem to be plural, but actually what they are? They are singular in nature. And some subjects, singular, a pair, okay, because we are talking about one pair. When you speak many pairs, then you will use plural. Next is, some subjects seem to be singular, but they are plural. How? See, for example, but they are actually plural. Can you give any example? Who you all are? Otherwise, what should I call you? Children. What you will speak? Speak any sentence with children. All children are. It means children seem to be singular, but actually it is plural. And what we will use? We use it with plural verb. Okay, for example, the people are. Okay, then the cattle. The cattle are grazing in the field. They seem to be singular, but actually what they are plural ones. Right? So clear this one till here. Huh? The crowds. Yes. No, the crowd is. Next is. The next, yes, news. News is seen to be plural, but it is singular. Wages. They seem to be plural, but they take singular verb. Crowd is singular. Right? These are also the examples. So next is some quantities. With some quantities. Okay, they take singular verb. For example, ₹500. What you will say? Speak any sentence with. Is a large amount. You are taking it with singular. Singular verb is used here. Next. 5 kilometers is a short distance. With kilometers you are using is singular verb. Then afterwards, for example, the bananas are sold for 1 dozen a kilo. Okay, it is again taking singular verb, right? Okay. Then afterwards, we are talking about collective nouns. Okay, collective noun. So collective noun, when it is taken as one unit, if it is used as one unit, then what we use singular verb. When it is used as one unit, it will take singular verb. For example, the committee has given its verdict. Okay, or the committee has given its judgment. It means committee, I am taking it as one unit. The crowd here, you can say. Okay, now, but if it is broken or if it is taken as individuals, if the members of the committee, they are taken as individuals, then what it is going to take? It is going to take plural verb. What it is going to take? It is going to take plural verb. For example, the members of the jury or all the members of the committee or jury have given their opinions. So here I am, the members of the society. If I will speak about society, then it will take singular verb. But if I will take all the members of the society, then it will take plural verb. Similarly, committee, similarly this. Okay, the crew members. Okay, amassed at the deck of the ship. Okay, right? So it means when I'm taking crew, means all the members of the crew. Actually, the crew can also take plural verb. Okay, because why? Because it is crew means all the members of the group. Right? So last one, the main rule is when there is use of relative pronoun. Now, when there is use of relative pronoun. So now in this case, the verb follows the antecedent. What happens? The verb follows the antecedent. What is relative pronoun? See, here, who is making the relation of the subject with the rest of the sentence? With other part of the sentence? So this is what? This is relative pronoun. Who, which, whose, right? These are the examples of relative pronouns. Okay. So now, in this case, what is antecedent now? Antecedent, who is referring to what? Who is referring to what? The boy. So the boy is the antecedent of the relative pronoun. So now here, what will be the answer? The boy who is standing. And it will follow the antecedent. Yes. Okay, suppose I change. They, who, are criminals. See here this example. They who dash coming to our house are criminals. So here who, what it is referring to? They. So they is plural. So here what it will be? Right? So these are all the rules of subject verb concord. Okay? So let us revise these rules once again. So first of all, what we have revised, the first rule was the if two singular subjects, they are joined with and, then what they take? They take singular, they take plural verb. For example, Ram and Shyam are good friends. Okay. He and his friends are coming to our house. So, but if the two subjects, they refer to one idea, if they refer to one idea, then they, what they will take? Singular verb. For example, bread and butter, rice and curry, slow and steady. Okay. Time and tide waits for none. Right? They refer to one idea. Next is, but when the two subjects are there, okay, singular subjects are there and they refer to one person also. What they refer to? They refer to one person only. Then what they also take? They also take singular verb. For example, my friend and philosopher is my guide. Okay, it means my friend and philosopher, or my guide is my friend and philosopher. They refer to one idea, right? Next is, if two subjects, they are joined with together, with and, as well as and with, then what they refer to? They refer to the first subject. Okay, for example, I as well as he, am interested. Okay, now you remember. Okay, now if two subjects, they are joined with either or neither nor or only or, then how they will, what they will refer? They will refer to the, they will take singular verb. But if two or more subjects are there, then they will refer to the nearer one. Two cases are there. Okay. Right. Next, afterwards, if together and besides is there, then again they will take singular verb. Right. Name of the country is singular verb. Collective noun, singular verb. Some seem to be singular, but they are plural in nature. They will take singular. Some seem to be singular, but they are plural in nature. Then they take plural verb. Okay. Then some quantities, we have done the example of quantities. Okay. Kilometers. Okay. Then dozen one. Okay. Yes, dash rupees note. Okay. And last one is when there is use of relative pronoun. So that's all. Clear to you all? Don't get confused with the rules. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay. You will have to do the practice. And you know, for MCQs, it can be in any form. And you people will see that more than one option is correct. Okay. These are of complex type MCQs. Okay. So be careful. Okay, don't think that it will be pick and choice ones. Okay, bas ek hi answer aapko correct lagega, that will no. It will be a complicated one if MCQs are there. Right, so be careful. You should have deep understanding of each and every topic. So that's all for today. And in the next class, we will revise chapter number 1, letter to God.